All right, so welcome to the fifth Q Simulator podcast. I'm your host, Microwave Gaming.
And I'm your co-host, that's wrong show. Your co-host, Game Addict.
Game Addict. Game Addict.
Game Addict loves butt stuff.
Butt stuff. New emo. We just got it. Come check it out on Twitch, twitch.tv/microwave_gaming. Selfless plug, shameless plug. Go out there.
What do we do over on www.twitch.tv/microwave_gaming every Friday night at 10:30 Pacific time?
Yeah, so today's, I guess we did at 10:30. Got a little bit late today. That's my bad. But we do a podcast where we talk about everything that happened during the week in Rainbow Six Siege while we sit here in the queue and wait for a game, because we can never find a fucking game this late at night with other people. So we're going to sit here in queue and just talk about some problems or some new things that are coming into the game. And so far, now there's two things that people are being like nutting over. Now we're going to go ahead and get over the cosmetic thing because that's the biggest news. It's not my favorite. I'm not the most excited about it, but we're going to go ahead and talk about it first. The new Elite skin, Game Addict, what did they show us?
Man, they showed us Robert De Niro.
What is this shit?
I don't know.
You think it looks like Robert De Niro? I think he looks like Menard Keenan from Tool, the lead singer, right? Like,
yeah.
Prying open my third eye. Like, bro, like, what is this? He's combing his little mohawk.
He's
like,
combing his little mohawk. Pulse got some hair. They gave him some Rogaine. And
oh my God.
He sprouted that little mohawk, man. And
it's kind of cringy.
The animation's cringy. Yeah, it's, I agree. Cringy. I'm definitely not a fan.
No.
Blackbeard's was so cool. Blackbeard's like, hey, I'm watching you. You're going down. Right? Yeah. That was badass. That's like, oh, this is Rainbow Six. I'm going to get it all on Blackbeard and make you look stupid. Now with Pulse, I feel like I'm just trying to look good. What?
It feels like Vietnam veteran Blackbeard, the ace of spades. He's going to kill you and fuck you up. And then it's like, Pulse, whoa.
Hey, baby.
Like, dude, what? Dude, there's going to be some trolls out there, bro. Like, I'm definitely going to buy it because, like, you know, I'm going to support the game and stuff. But it's definitely not the neatest one. It's by far the most cringiest. It's like a step in the wrong direction, like, in my opinion. You know, you have, like, the Nazi uniform for Thermite, which is okay, you know. And then you have, which is like a party trick, I guess. It's okay. You have the Twitch. I think it's fantastic, actually. The Twitch is probably my second favorite the Blackbeard, obviously.
I agree. Yes.
I mean, even the Twitch has uses. I don't know if you've ever tried to shoot her drone while she has the Elite skin, but it's difficult.
Yeah,
it kind of blends in a little bit.
It's damn near invisible.
It is.
Yeah, it's invisible. A lot darker. It is.
So, and it can hide pretty good. So I think that animation, and plus her Elite uniform, isn't like some era throwback or something like that. Not too sure on the French history.
I feel
the military.
It is like a little bit of a throwback, but I'm not sure either.
But I think it
looks older. I mean, Twitch in general looks more high tech. She looks like she'd be a little more futuristic, I guess, with her little
her face is
arm controller.
I don't like her face, but the uniform and the animation is fantastic. It's true to her nature. It's kind of playful, you know. But like a little drone's I'm coming to get you, you know, like, friend. But this Pulse shit is cringy, dude. Like, the only thing it's missing is long fingernails and a fucking fedora. Like, that's
and
the only
honestly,
thing missing, bro.
I saw one Photoshop. That's all it is missing. But I saw one Photoshop where he was smiling, right? It was like that add a fucking smile app or some shit.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever the fuck it is. But I gotta tell you, just adding a smile actually would make the animation that much better, because now it feels like a troll. Like, right now it's fucking cringy. He's combing his hair back. He's so fucking cool. He's Pulse, you know. Fuck that shit. if he throws that little smile like, I'm the fucking man. Pulse, bitch.
Whoa.
Like, all right, now we're trolling. Right now I have more of a reason to use my thing, because I'm gonna it's fun to get those animations. When he's serious about it, it's just fucking cringy.
Dude, it makes me like I would just want to like take a bath after I saw it. I was like, ugh, like bugs and stuff are all over me.
Right.
Man.
I was excited for the uniform though. Like I was excited.
The uniform's
to
okay. I guess it, you know, a lot of people are saying it looks like a taxi driver and stuff. But
well, so really, it looks like Robert De Niro from Taxi Driver, like the Mohawk, everything. Like when I saw the side by side on Reddit, I giggled a little bit because it looked true. It looked like, hey, here's some inspiration. Make this, because I'm into this right now, guys. And that's make exactly what they did.
I watched this TV show. It was great. Now make this happen in the game. Like, what am I supposed to do with this? I don't know. We'll put it on Pulse. Why not? He has no hair. Let's give him Mohawk.
Right? Yeah. That's right. Yeah, you don't have to shave anybody. We'll just add it.
I think it's cringy. I think it's a step in the wrong direction. It's something that we kind of didn't want. You know, I think when the animations, the MVP screens came out, a lot of people were like, oh, this is great, you know. But then we started worrying, like, oh, it's going to be like Call of Duty where we're doing, like, dabbing and, like, trotting, horse trotting, and we're all wearing pink armor and stuff. Like, see, right. I like fun. I use the pink camo. I think it's kind of cool in my opinion. I like to goof around. But like in all seriousness, like this game, it doesn't fit the game at all. It's very cheesy.
No, it doesn't.
And if you really look at Pulse's lips, like they look like little vagina, like with an over bite. Like it's just, it's disgusting looking. it's horrible looking. I don't like it at all. It's kind of cringy. Like I said, I think the smile would have been better, but, I don't like, I'm hoping that they don't continue this path. I'm going to have it for the troll factor and to just, I guess, support Ubisoft, you know, because, I mean, you know, they're trying to make a good game and stuff. And but I think it's definitely down the wrong path. They hit a gold mine with Blackbeard. They did it really good with Twitch. Thermites was okay. Nothing wrong with that. But
well,
definitely,
I remember it all started with Capcan being very serious.
Yeah,
we forgot
about Capcan. That's a good
animation.
One, actually. Yeah.
Right. It seems like a very tactical kind of, what you would imagine Rainbow Six to be, right? A show off, but that's what kicked it all off when everybody was fucking drooling over that when they first released that.
Well, I guess we forgot the Rook one too. The Rook one's a very good one. I really like the Rook one.
Yeah.
That's so true to his nature. He picks out bullets out of his chest because he's got the plates, and then he just smacks it like a big gorilla, dude. It's fantastic. Now I don't like the look of it. I think he looks like Buzz Lightyear. I mean, that joke's been made and hammered into the ground, but he really does. I don't like the helmet at all, but I mean, everything else about it is fantastic. I'm really kind of worried to see what the weapon skins look like. It might be some greaser outsider, need a haircut greaser stuff going on. You know, it's got some combs and
you my boy, Pony boy,
you my boy. Stay true to yourself. Like
stay golden, Pony Boy.
Stay golden, Pony Boy.
Yeah, I hope we don't see some of that shit, all right? I really hope we're gonna get something that's thought out. Cause to be honest, I don't enjoy Twitch's elite skin for her guns.
Right.
I think they're a little
basic,
boring.
But they're right? They're true to the weapons themselves. Like they're true. Like, it's not show-offy. It's very basic. I like that, you know? But then again, I also like the big pink skins, you know, and big pink stuff.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Nah. No, and it doesn't have to be flashy for me. I just, I don't know. I like how they do gloss on these guns. I think gloss looks really good on these guns.
Oh,
shine
yeah.
looks really nice. So to put these matte colors on it and to make them very dull is just boring to me. And I'm not saying they have to be bright pink or bright green or the new, like, what's it, canary yellow or some shit, or plasma pink.
I like the plasma pink. I want it.
Right. Well, we like these, but so as for a serious skin, I just would like to see something other than, like, a matte type paint job.
Right. Now, we all have to admit here, the best F2 skin is definitely the shark skin. Whoever made that, whoever artist made that, you're brilliant. You're a beautiful person. I'm pretty sure it's this chick. I think it's the chick that did the IQ cosplay. When the game first came out, I don't know if you can see this picture, you can Google it, IQ cosplay, her holding a beer, but she's the actual one that came up with F2 skin, and that is by far one of the best skins, period, in my opinion. It's amazing. Mm-hmm. So
I
would love
to
see it. It's very thoughtful, you know, but these new skins that are coming out, I have no problem with it. I just really don't like the Pulse skin. So hopefully we don't continue down this path where all of a sudden, you know, some we're picking like Tachanka and he's dabbing. Now I know Reddit would fucking flip shit, like they'd probably love it, but in my opinion, I wouldn't want it. No dabbing, please. No fidget spinners. I just right. really
this
hope
isn't Destiny. This is like we're not gonna have dancing emotes coming into this.
Oh my
like,
god, dude. I'm so nervous about it because it just might happen, you know? I mean, if it sells, you know, I mean, what are you going to do, right?
Right. No, and I get that. I mean, this is a business and businesses evolve and yep. games change and they try and reinvent themselves and bring in new stuff. But everybody knows that Rainbow Six is built off of realism or tries to be as realistic as possible without breaking the kind of immersion of a game, that it still right. has to be a game. So...
Now,
you know, if we do get into dabbing, I think that that's the end of like what the true soul of the Rainbow Six would be.
Now, you know, going back to the skins and stuff, I talked about it a long time ago in my videos about realistic headgears. I don't mind the crazy kooky stuff. I got a problem with that. I just really wish that they would do more of the realistic stuff. You know, try to keep it like maybe like a 60-40, like a 60 realistic, maybe 40. But like back, mm-hmm. you know, a few months ago, they were coming with clown masks and all this kind of stupid stuff. And now we get this new elite skin. Really hope that they don't, like I said, don't continue down this path. No more clown stuff, this colorful, flashy stuff. Let's get some realistic headgear in. Let's get like some ghillie suits or something. I don't know, but... That's a really good one for Glaz, actually, a ghillie suit. That'd be really cool.
It would be. Now, I'd be really interested to see. I guess we
would it be pay to win?
No. Mm-hmm. It wouldn't be pay to win. I think it would maybe make you a little bit more obvious to see. I mean, we are talking about a game where there's no grass. I mean, ghillie suits are meant to disguise you, right? We're talking about indoors, and if for a good player, a little bit of your suit sticks out around a corner, giving them the little bit of an edge they need to know you are there about to peek that, you know, that could be a disadvantage to you. That's all I'm saying. Like,
well, maybe like on in the inside, or if they're on top of a building, obviously, but like, you know, mm-hmm. ghillie suits and stuff are made to obscure the object of man. So our eyes, this is like a direct, like a quote from like all the snipers and stuff, like you're looking for the silhouette of a man, and the best way to remove that is to make it look like it's not a man. And so like maybe if it's a little bit bulgier, you know, the head and the shoulders are like kind of like meshed together, almost like it looks like this just big blob, it could be treated like it's a lot harder to see, you know what I mean? And that's what I mean by pay to win. Like, it's a lot harder to see because you don't see that perfect outline of that person. You know, it could be just this big right. circle thing. Right. So
I just don't think it would have the same effect, at least in this game. Yeah. So we see ghillie suits in PUBG. And they're effective in PUBG because PUBG has, you know, environments. It right. has fields. It has bushes which you sit in. And they really do obscure you. I've seen the clips online. I've seen highlight reels of people just walking right past. Oblivious. Somebody. I mean, being right next to them, and I mean, so just in this game, so that's why I pay to win. I don't feel like it'd be pay to win for you.
That makes sense.
The person
yeah.
who is using it, it would definitely be pay to win. You've paid for this skin. Now the other people are winning more because you're using it.
Now for our next topic, I think this is the biggest thing ever. We touched on it last week actually, and it's insane how you talked about it last week on our podcast. Literally last week. And we get a dev blog about mm-hmm. servers. You want to talk about that for a minute? Because you were talking about that last week.
It's not just actually like a dev blog, really, as much as that's like the TTS right now. That's
right. It wasn't a dev blog. It was on Reddit.
Right. Right. That's what you can experience right now on the technical test server. And these are supposedly, guys, the 60 tick rate servers. And... we're on 50.
We have
right
no
now,
way to know right? that. Yeah, we're on 50 right now.
Right. We had no way to know that. We were told we were on 60 after fucking, I think it was year one, right? They're like, oh, we're going to upgrade to 60. Woohoo.
Yeah, then
they kind of, right, they sneakily were like, oh, well, we've really been on 50 and we're really going to give you 60 later on. Like, we're working on it. So right now, testing that, like, I got to play on it. Have you gotten to play on that, Microwave?
No, I haven't gotten a chance. I have to download it. And it takes, like, because right now I'm testing out the Ghost Recon beta thing mm-hmm. for the PvP. Mm-hmm. I can't really talk about it because it's under NDA, obviously, but I've been dabbling around with that, and that takes like 80 gigs of my hard drive, so I would have to remove that and install the TTS just to get that. So
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. That's and space will be talked about in a little bit, but right now, having played it, I can tell you it feels smooth. It feels pretty good. I enjoyed my time. Yeah. Now it's weird because when you join this, guys, you are not your level. What you originally play on, you're put back at level zero. So if you've played this game for a long time, you are probably going to be put with people who have not, or maybe a lower level, right? Who are brand new. So it can be a little frustrating, but you can feel the difference. And you kind of get to see some of the new charms that they're adding. One that I saw I hadn't seen was a motocross helmet.
Motocross helmet? I think I've seen that one. Yeah, on Reddit, somebody leaked this whole giant spreadsheet of all the charms, including the ones that are coming out in October. I'm going to write that down. We'll talk about that a little bit later, but keep going. Yeah, I see what you're saying.
Yeah. But yeah, so having played these servers, it's really exciting that they're finally doing this. And from what we understand, this should be like the 3.0 patch, I think, that these servers are coming out.
Yeah.
That's going to be after finals.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be after finals, which is finals is what, August 29th, I believe? That's what they said?
25th, 26th. GamesCon is the 24th through the 26th.
Okay, so we're going to be getting more information about that. So really, really excited about that. I think it's going to be great. But it's just insane that you mentioned that last week, and then all of a sudden there's like a post about it, right? We talked about it. And I was watching Mache and Matimio. If you guys know who they are, I'll put a link down below in this description. They were playing it together, and they were mentioning, you know, they have 2,000-3,000 viewers, 4,000 viewers put together. And they were saying that it feels great. They don't know if it's a placebo effect. It looks great. It feels great. Hit Reg is on point. He went by slow-mo on some of the things, frame by frame, and it looked great. So I think it's the biggest thing. Once we get these servers up and running, it's definitely going to be a big, big change for the game, because I know, like, for me, my ping is just wretched, especially going to East Coast. I have 140, 160 ping lately for the past 2 weeks when we go to play East Coast America.
Well, I also feel like there's been, like, a degradation in the servers for some reason.
Yeah, I would definitely agree with that, too.
They've not been performing as well, I feel like, but... This will hopefully change that, like you're saying, man. I really hope so.
This is a big move, because this is the third and final pillar that they've been really hammering in. So it looks like they'll be giving everything that they've actually said that they would be giving to us during Operation Health. Now the thing is, like, for me, Operation Health is like, it's a big revamp. It's making this game what it was supposed to be a long time ago. What they're doing, especially now, they're actually going to be redoing some of the patches. The Ultra HD pack, the texture pack and stuff. And they're going to be redoing some of the how the patches work. So basically, there's these things called forges. And they basically, when they patch something, they just overwrite these forges. And all these forges are accumulating in the backlog, and they're not even being used. So I guess during the next patch, 2.2.2, which is, it's already out, actually, I believe, right? Is that correct? We don't know, right? What's this patch?
The data that you're talking about is going to be Season 3. That will be start with Season 3, and that essentially will be ushering in the change with, what's it called? Cafe.
Right.
So, you know, they're going to be changing the textures on Cafe. This is kind of the start with that, this change of the Forge. This way that they're streamlining these HD textures and these texture packs for us. By the way, you can only use this new HD, Ultra HD texture pack if you have a graphics card with at least 6 gigabytes of VRAM on it.
Right.
So it is for the newer people. Right. I will not personally be able to use this. I'm not a part of that cool club, guys. So
hey,
like, this for me don't mean shit. I don't even give a fuck about this.
Yeah, well, but it means what for me. You guys will see it on stream and YouTube.
So what it means for that, I mean, for you, is a better looking game overall.
Right. They said 60%
for us. Keep going.
I think they said it was like a 60% decrease in. No. Okay. Yeah. We'll talk about the time later. But I think they said that if you're able to access the Ultra HD package with the 6 gigabyte of VRAM, you get the actual source of the environment, like the 100% true source that the developers made. So it's going to look really, really good for people who have 1080s and 1080 Ti's and all that good stuff. So don't worry, guys. I do run HD, high, ultra settings, everything. It's not the best gameplay-wise because it doesn't make everybody glow and it doesn't make the corners and the shadows perfect, but it looks beautiful. So we will be able to see that, especially on my YouTube channel. But you were saying, sorry, I didn't want to interrupt. I did interrupt, but go ahead, finish what you're saying.
No, that's completely fine because you actually kind of segued into what I was going to be going to talk about, which was loading times based off of that. So it's, I mean, for people like me who don't have that 6 gigabytes, it affects you too. Because they're swapping this out and they are kind of redesigning how these patches will be layering on top of each other and going to be working. Everybody will generally be loading faster. The game's not going to be looking through your files, trying to find what you need to load. So if you are one of those people on an old hard drive, an actual HDD, then
that takes forever to load.
Right, you're going to see some improvement for
not
yourself.
Not huge. Well, they did say on PC that they don't know the estimated time because there's so many variations. Of course, you could have a 960, you could have a 1070. It's, you know, we don't know. They don't know what you have. But they did say it was a 10% decrease in loading time across all consoles. That's huge, actually. Yes, a 10%? That's awesome. So basically, they're going to be redoing the forges. They're going to be taking them out. And it's going to be, they're relaying the pathway for all the patches. And to me, guys, now I know this is not flashy. It's not cool. It's not hip. You're not getting all these crazy things like Alpha Packs. But that's exactly, to me, what Operation Health is. Now, it's a very boring article. It is not cool at all, but it is exactly, it's very dry. Like, all this stuff's very dry, but this is exactly what Operation Health is to me. It's like, I feel like they've been just cramming. I've said it time and time again. They're just cramming all this meat down this tube, and it's just blowing out the seams, and it's just trash, right? But they're now reinforcing this tube. They're making it better. They're streamlining their process, so they're not cramming, 20 pounds of meat down a 10-pound, whole tube, you know what I mean? So it's like, you know what I mean? So it's a terrible analogy, I guess, but that's the way it's, I feel no, like.
It actually still works because when you think about game development timelines and what you're trying to accomplish with your list of wants versus needs, so things we need are servers that are going to be reliable. We need hit reg code that is going to be matching up with host and client.
Yep.
And then we need our wants, which is like Alpha Packs,
it's flashy. You got to keep them entertained.
The flashy stuff. But we basically need those two major pillars of hit reg and servers to be super strong. And they're getting taken care of.
I kind of worried about that too because a lot of these people, again, they want this flashy stuff. They want all this beautiful elite skin like we're going to be seeing on August the 9th. And it's like, well, that's great and all. It looks cool, but like, dude, this is Operation Health. We're here to get the game working better. We're here to get it improved so later on down the road we don't have to deal with this shit. You know what I mean? Like, they can take the year and a half, and they're just smoothing that peanut butter over. They're just making it nice and smooth and beautiful. And I'm really hoping they keep with this. And of course they are. They're gonna be doing the maps and the characters. Retexturing and stuff, but like this patch thing, like, it's very subtle and it really didn't make waves on Reddit. I think it got like 60 upvotes, and that's kind of disappointing because, again, to me, that is exactly what Operation Health is. They're doing things on your computer, like they're removing some files to make it easier and like less of a download. It's gonna make patching more streamlined. Like, I mean, then again, patching's not really that big of a problem, but like, hopefully it doesn't cause more errors. They're just making it smoother overall. And so, again, that's what I like to see.
Absolutely.
Now, speaking of making this game better, dude, did you see how many people have played this game in the past, 20 months? Is that what it is? 20 months, I think it is?
Has it been? Yeah. About, I think it's been 20. You're right.
Yeah.
Holy shit. Yeah. I don't know if you could miss it, right? But yeah, 20 months and 20 million players, man.
That is insane.
Fucking insane.
20 million players. Now, I don't know if they're actually playing because we can never find a game. Maybe they're all silver and gold, but 20 million players have at least tried.
That's kind of the hard thing about these games, right? It's like,
why are more people high ranking?
If I play Dota and there's 10 million active players in Dota at one given time, and I can find a game instantly because I'm a piece of shit and I suck at that game, right? But if I was like the best at that game, I'm sure I could only basically find a game if it was in this kind of super tiered level. And yeah. I'm going to see the same people over and over, just like we do.
Yep.
Just like we do in Rainbow. Yep. We play the same team five times in a row because our pool is so small. So it's not like it discredits the numbers, right? There are definitely 20 million people, but they just happen to be a lot of silvers and golds, I think.
And I would say that most people are actually playing on the consoles. I mean, obviously, the game itself is easier to run on the console.
Yes.
And, you know, you just pop it in, and that's fantastic. But what is, I would say, like, it's like 70% of the people, or, I mean, it's untold numbers. It's not official. Like, I haven't seen anything official saying, like, 80% of the community is console. But I would say, like, 70 or 75% of the community is definitely console. Like,
PC. It's a very accessible way to get into games. You know, I played console for a long time.
Right.
I grew up with a fucking original Nintendo, right? And we'll need to loan the disc. the cartridge and everything. And
reset.
Right. You know, I had the Duck Hunt gun and everything. I got it right behind me. So it's like...
Fancy.
I've played console. I understand that it's an easy way to get into games. And it's usually a lot cheaper than building even a low-end PC.
Right. You know, it's complicated, you know. I mean, you gotta have all these programs to like back each other up, you know, and do other things. Mm-hmm. It's a lot easier than just popping in a disc and, you know, plug and play, essentially. The PC, exactly, you've gotta really fine tune it. You know, on my computer right now, just even like streaming, I have 7 Chrome windows open, including this backdrop, Discord, Banana, Steam, OBS, and I'm splitting everything, the audio and the video, into my stream PC. So I'm using two computers to stream this live, you know, and like that's just insane. Right. As opposed to a console, you just plug it up into a computer via an Elgato, or not sponsored, by the way, I'm just making that up, and you're good to go. You just put on OBS, you're good to go, right? But like, PC is a lot more difficult to really get your hands around. So I would definitely say like 70-80% are consoles. So
yeah. And on top of that, so here's, I guess, like, I don't know if this skews the numbers or not with console. You know, if you have an Xbox, I only know for Xbox. I'm sorry if I'm ignorant to PlayStation guys, but you know, it's, I know that if I have a gold account, if I'm playing online, I can just continuously make accounts on my Xbox.
You can actually
Rainbow Six, and
a lot of people have been saying that on YouTube, like, why do you have like a million accounts? Because, you know, on PC we could just change our name in an instant, but it doesn't change our actual account. Like, it, our account is still there. It doesn't change our rank, it doesn't change anything. It's the same account. And so a lot of people are confused because, you know, I changed my name because of Stream Snipers. I stream every single day, damn near. And, you know, when people see your name on there, they go on your stream and then they watch what you're doing and then they counteract exactly your plays. And so we change your name to kind of hide it. I mean, almost every single streamer does it. Mache does this. Matimio does it. They all do it, except for the pro players. They don't give a shit. They're so good. They don't give a shit. Right. But like, I'm not a pro player. So my little sneaky tricks, you know, are, I have to hold dear to me. And so a lot of people, like you said, they change their name on Xbox or PS4. I don't know if it's on PS4 or not, but it doesn't work that way on the computer. It doesn't work that way on Uplay. So once you change your name, you still have your account. So I wanted to go ahead and clarify that, because I get that question a lot in the comments. Like, why are you continuously changing your name and your accounts? Like, is it because you want to restart to gold? Like, no, I'm still playing at Plat 1 or Diamond level.
Yeah, that's the thing, like, people understand. We don't go back to gold.
We don't go back to gold.
Play
we still play. Level. Yeah, exactly. Even when we're just messing around, we're still playing a Plat 1 and Diamond level. It's all there. And so a lot of people are like, well, we was making this new account. Like, no, dude. Like, well, what are you talking about? My accounts are Plat 1 and Diamond. You can R6DB them, you know. But I know it's kind of off subject. We kind of went off the trail there. But I just want to clarify that, because I know a lot of YouTubers, especially the big YouTubers, they have that problem. So, and I've never actually addressed that. So I'm going to go ahead and address that now on the QC.
And so here's also another thing I just want to like clarify about these alt accounts, these, what some people would call Smurfs, is because when we get these accounts, a lot of the times now, if you see people using these accounts for clips and posting content, you know, you can look at all the names, you can R6DB them, you can find out what rank they are, what rank that account is, who they are, all that jazz. Right. I only have two accounts, right? But both of them, the goal, at least for everybody I know personally, when they have multiple accounts on PC, since they're all different accounts, is to get Diamond over and over and over again. We like to fucking punish ourselves to get that thing. and we pay for it every single time if we want to get a new one. So it's not about smurfing, like getting easy clips. It's about getting clips at a new level on a new account so we can possibly try and get better stats.
Now, I know on my other account, the one I play with subscribers, it took me 290 games to hit Diamond. Now, a lot of people will be like, oh, you know, that's because you're trash. And it's true. I'm not the greatest player in the world. But it took me 290 games with like a 65% win ratio to get Diamond. Like, it wasn't just like, you know how like you could play, you win 20 games in a row, you get Diamond. Like, I can't do that, you know. The pros can, right. But I can't do that. Yeah. It took me 290 games, man. So,
I mean, all right. So here's the difference with that, right? You said the pros can't, but the pros are also playing with each other.
True.
They are forming these awesome five stacks where a lot of
death
times
squads, turbo fuckers.
We call them death squads, turbo fuckers. Either way, I mean, we love these guys, everybody, and we're not trying to like
degrade
them. They're awesome people. They're
great,
fucking amazing at this game.
I got wrecked last night by them.
Right. And then so what do we do? We're like, let's do MH70 rushes against the pros. Like, fuck it, because why not?
Right.
Right.
Gotta have some fun.
Right. We do try and have fun when we can. And I think that's a big difference when we do these accounts.
So another thing I want to talk about is the dog glitch. Right? New thing.
Fuck. God.
Right. Right. Now, we're not going to say how it's done. You can look at Reddit. You can look at Twitter. It's all over. It's becoming
this
thing. You can easily find it. I'm not going to share how to do it. Not because trying to be a high horse here or anything like that. It's just I think it's like a really weird exploit. Like, I don't know. Like, and it's not something that's been there since day one. Like, the other thing about like shooting the floor, like that's been there since day one. They've used it in the pro league multiple times. They even use it in the pro league after that video.
Right. You're referring to
the echo
shooting, right? Shooting out the floor, which has been used in ESL.
Yes.
Since day one. This is not something new.
It's not something new, but this is new. And this is why I'm not going to be talking about how to do it. Now we talked about the pro mod. And you just decrease your settings. We didn't say what settings they were. We didn't say how to decrease the settings. We just said that's how it is and that's how it works. Now, hopefully with the Ultra HD pack, they actually changed that. That's actually a good thing. I didn't think about that.
Well, I mean, so that's kind of the thing about PCs, right?
There's always a way
around. So customizable, right? There's always a way around. I mean, I've seen, I can't remember the guy's YouTube channel for the name of me, but his whole goal on his channel is to make video games run on basically if you had a computer from 2000.
Right.
So the lowest possible settings that you can make it. How far can he take it down? Exactly. Like Counter-Strike 1.6 graphics on Witcher 3. Like, let's do that. That's what he does. That's basically what it turns this game into. So it's like, we don't condone this type of stuff. We're just here to tell you about it, guys.
Right. So this glitch, basically you get a shit ton of stim pistols and you could just keep spamming it. You could just like we actually saw it happen. We got a Twitch clip played to us. We're not gonna say the names or anything because we're not gonna put people on blast. It's not what we do here. Unless, you know, it's something big. And we can tell the other side of the story, like Mache. Like, we talked about Mache and his ban, but we also tell the other side of the story of how and why he got banned and why he got the ban lifted, because it wasn't his fault. Now, this person, we're not going to say his name because we don't know his side of the story, so we're not going to put him on blast. But we saw him clearly using it at the Diamond level, one of the highest players in North America, and I think like top 60 players in the world was using this dog glitch, and he was just running around like a shit ton of HP and just using on everybody. Just and I really hope it gets fixed. It's not a good thing. So people are using it at the higher caliber levels. I don't think they won't be using a pro league because that's an automatic disqualification.
Oh,
so we won't see
banned.
That.
You're bye bye.
You're gone, dude. Yes, but we are seeing in the higher rank gameplay for sure, 100%. That happened today, and I'm really disappointed in the individuals doing this. But again, it's in the game.
Yeah,
who am I to judge? You know, there's nothing I can do about it. You know, so hopefully they get it fixed. And again, basically the dog glitch. We're not going to say how it happens or how it's done, but basically you get a shit ton of stim pistols and there's like no reload on it. It's like Team Fortress where you're shooting the little needles. It's exactly like that. And you just keep healing people. And so only headshots really.
Yeah. Only headshots matter. But in a game where nobody's perfect, and there is recoil. You know, obviously, always aim for the head guys. But if you fuck up and you're going against this, it's going to wreck your day.
It's going to piss you off.
Yes, it will.
So another thing that's big, we actually experienced this yesterday. Some asshat tried to use it against us, and we wrecked him in the face. A Valkyrie glitch. Now, most of you guys don't know, you throw a Valkyrie glitch outside a bank in a certain area. Again, we're not going to say how it's done, but the Valkyrie glitch...
It's been very prevalent lately.
It is, yes. I think across, I'm so surprised we saw it yesterday. Yeah, especially console. Mm-hmm. You see it on Reddit literally every day. You go to new, and you'll see at least one post every 2 hours about this glitch. Basically, you throw a cam in a certain spot, and then you just keep spotting. You can spot everybody on the map, and it just keeps pinging, and everybody can see you. So there's nothing you can do about it. The camera can't see you, but it can mark you, and that mark just shows everything. It doesn't matter where you hide.
I mean, it's basically like being under Kvetta's interrogation all the time. You know, it's pinging you, and it may be lagged a second, but the moment that you stop moving and it pings you, you're fucked.
You're dead. Or you're
right. You're basically
known.
Dead.
Yeah.
Right.
And so, you know, we experienced that yesterday. He tried to open up the door, and we all went to the back, and we all just pre-aimed the shit out of that door. And luckily, you got it. I'm pretty sure it was like midair. You got it like right before it landed.
It had basically just about landed on the brick. So and I got it. It felt good, but it was
fuck that guy.
Right, fuck that guy. It's thank God this was confirmed on fucking Twitter by Epi on August 9th when Pulse's Elite skin drops. That will be a fix, a soft patch that is coming.
So it's getting fixed.
Yes, it is getting fixed in what is that? That's like 5 days, 4 days.
So August the 9th,
4 days,
we will see a Valk cam glitch fix on bank.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Thank God for that.
And so thank God for that, because oh my fucking God, what a terrible thing to happen. Yeah. And so it also like begs the question, people have a lot of time on their hands. How do they find these types of glitches like Doc's glitches where you know, again, we're not going to tell you how it's done, but it doesn't.
I was going to interrupt you. I didn't know if you were going to say it. I was like, please don't say it.
Right. No, it's not a very intuitive thing to discover. That's what I'm getting at. It's not something that you're just like, oh, it was that easy to do this. Like,
well, I think people were messing around. You know how we mess around? We jump around. We just, you know, we're like teabagging each other. Like, and then like I fell through the floor on plane the other day on stream.
Right.
While
I remember
that.
Yeah.
I fell right through the floor. Like, okay, so like if I go back and watch that footage, maybe I can reenact that because we were just messing around, right?
And that's what happens.
Well,
right. That's exactly how you're supposed to test a game.
We all know how they test stuff there, right? They just, you know, move the joysticks around and it looks good and they do it. Now, you may laugh about that, but yeah, exactly. But there's some stuff that should have been tested. Like for once, the Mira ejection, you can run up and melee it back when it was released.
Right,
like, did they not think of that? Like, what? It was terrible, right? But they didn't think of that. And that to me just shows how much they put into testing. Now, I could be just shit talking here and they could be putting way more out there. And I don't know behind the scenes.
I mean,
I do, in a sense,
only because of my experience. And it is such fucked up. But it can be so hard to catch something as simple like that, because if you're... you know, if you're guy who made it, you know, or your small team who made that, who coded that together to make that work, says, oh yeah, it's good, we've tested it, you know, hopefully you wouldn't take their word on it and you would continue to test it, right?
Right.
But it's like, so if you find something, it's like, all right, did it happen? Yes, it happened. Can I make it happen again? I'm gonna check. I'm gonna redo it. It happened again. There's 100% frequency rate. I've performed it 10 out of 10 times. I'm submitting that as a bug. It needs to get fixed. Right. Now, what's the priority on that bug? Is it game breaking? Like Mira's was game breaking. That completely ruins her entire ability. Is it game breaking like that, or is it game breaking in the sense of like, oh well, it only happened, you know, 1 out of 10 times. It's not that big a deal. And when it did happen, it's not even noticeable. Like say if you hit a barricade and it still stayed up. Now that was a big problem. That's like 100% fucking. glitch to happen in the early stages of this game.
Oh my god.
And then
god.
It slowly got tailored out because they made better code for that.
Now, here's a crazy exploit. Now, who in chat or on YouTube, now let me know in the comments below, who remembers that fucking Pulse where they would reinforce the wall or the door, then they would crouch, and then they reinforce the wall, the door again, and they were prone, and they would keep doing this until they can get outside of the level before the attacker spawned. Oh my god, mm-hmm. dude. And then you would get C4'd. Oh my god. Let me know if in chat.
That was terrible, dude.
Oh, that was so game breaking because you couldn't do anything against it. You couldn't do anything. And it was so bad. You're like, I'm just done, dude. I quit for the day. I'm gonna go play The Division or whatever. That's what I used to play back in the day. Like, I was like, dude, yeah, I can't play this, dude. I cannot play this game anymore, dude. Because people were doing it. Even a rank, dude, it didn't matter. You were just, dude, right. Prep phase was over, bro. Shut down. Like, Jesus.
Back then, it was crazy, too, because even if you went shield, right? We would do, like, five-man recruits. Shield fapping was a thing, right? But then there was also, so people would throw C4. There was no damage mitigation with shields back then.
Yeah,
it was 100%. You were Montang, and somebody threw a C4 in front of you, you're fucked. Dead. Like, it did nothing.
You're gone. Right. So, out of here.
You're gone. Right. So we've obviously seen, this is, I guess, where people, you know, when they bitch about Operation Health, like, oh, it's not doing shit. This is terrible. I'm not enjoying it. Like, motherfucker, go back to day one.
Yes.
And enjoy yourself.
Then talk about it. Yeah. Because
right.
that
go
was
to vanilla.
Horrible. Right. Mm-hmm. Another thing I want to talk about is actually it really isn't to deal with the game, but it's more about the Pro League. I do want to incorporate Pro League more into this scene because I do feel that the pros, they need to be talked about more. I play with a lot of the pros sometimes, especially at night, and they're really good guys. A lot of them got a good heart, and they want to play this game daily. They want to be the best that they can, and you know, they're not really getting much money to do it, unfortunately. We talked about that, I think, in episode 3. But you know, I want to bring more pro talk about them, not actually to the show, but talk about them. Unfortunately, two teams that have always made it to Pro League got knocked out by two kind of unknown teams. Now,
two Greenhorns, actually.
Two Greenhorn teams, yes. Vitality and G-Bots, the EU scene, were knocked out by My Revenge and B-Genius. I think the way it works is they go to Challenger League to try to fight back their spot, kind of like what Omen did, you know, that whole Omen ominous kind of thing going on. You know, maybe they had to fight their way back up. The Omen Ominous thing was, they basically broke up. Anyways, so they'll be fighting back to the Challenger League to maybe get a spot. I think that's how it works. I'm not 100% sure. I'll have to look that up because I don't really follow the Challenger League stuff, but they were knocked out 2 days ago in a 2-0. They got 2-0'd. So it wasn't like it was a close game. I mean, they got fully wrecked. I believe it was like 5-2 on each map. So that means one of the maps that they even chose, they lost in, both teams. So I don't know if we'll see a shuffle. I don't, you know, because obviously those players have been there.
I don't think so. Yeah.
You think they'll stay?
It's unfortunate. I do. And so here's why I think they'll stay.
And this is for next season too, not this season.
Right. This is
a regulation.
They're going to stay together, though, throughout this. And my whole reasoning why is just because of the amount of support, I think, that Rainbow Six gets over in Europe in terms of tournaments. There's
Nordic,
like,
stuff.
Right. There's a bajillion tournaments compared to the NA scene. NA, fucking, what'd they say earlier? They have to wait, like, 2 weeks between games? Like, they're barely
long time,
playing
yeah.
in their pro league. When in the old format, it was a game every week. Game, right?
I was listening to Remorse yesterday, and I'll put a link in the description on his stream and YouTube. You can check him out. Really cool guy. He said that Canadian from CTM has only played 6 games in the past, like, 6 months. So, like, 6 official games.
That's crazy.
Now, that's insane to me, you know? And we all know Canadian. I'll put his Twitch link below. He's a really phenomenal player, great entry fragger, pulse player, and a really solid dude. He's won 2 championships, I believe, including the international.
Being the world champion.
Yeah, so he's the big dick, big dude. Like, you can't dispute his awesomeness in the game, and he's only played 6 games. Like, that's insane to me, right? Like, you're having these players that, especially the set NA, that want to play, but like, there's just not much going on. So I wonder if we will be getting some new stuff coming down the pipeline for the game, you know, especially since we're building the VG squad. They got their own game house now. They haven't moved there yet. I think they're moving there after the finals.
Right. I know they planned on moving there earlier, but I think they postponed it because of trying to get all the stuff together. They're leaving very soon. They're just trying to get prepared. So it's better to be prepared mentally for this stuff than worry about a new house. That shit is stressful. I've moved several times. It's stressful as fuck.
Yeah, especially you're going to the land as well. So it's like, that's just too much. Let's just keep in our comfort zone. And then we'll worry about the move afterwards, which is a good move. But the fact that they're having a gaming house, and I believe they're the only people to actually get paid. Now, I'm saying that because the streamers themselves on VG have stated multiple times that they get paid since they're on the team. So it's not me just leaking stuff. They've mentioned it multiple times on their stream. So it's 100% confirmed. I'm not just leaking anything. But they're one of the only, as far as I know, North American teams that get paid actual money every month or week or whatever it is, I don't know, to play. So hopefully we see more of that actually coming soon. I mean, I think that'd be fantastic, because then that would raise the stakes in the game, you know. So, and then maybe we get more championships, who knows. I think the pro league, I think the pro scene, it really needs a makeover, really needs some love.
Well, and specifically NA pros, or pro scene,
I mean,
needs love.
Yeah, I mean, the NA does too, because
I'm a little biased, you know.
Well, yeah, I mean, I get that, but I mean, in general, the pros need more love, in my opinion. I've said that from day one. And so I'm going to be trying to bring more love to the pro scene, whether it be this Q simulator, or maybe I make a series about it. I don't know. But I'm definitely going to be bringing more of the pro scene and the statistics and stuff to you guys, the viewers. So the last thing I want to talk about is the actual Chibi Charms. Super simple, super easy. Ubisoft, I'm not getting paid by this or anything like that. But the Chibis are on sale. You get like a Tachanka, Smoke, an Ash, an IQ, and a Montaigne, a Chibi, and it comes with an in-game code they're going to be releasing in October, and you get the Chibi code, and it gives you a Chibi in the game. So you get that Chibi in real life, like a Demi hero. I don't know if you've ever played Dota, guys, or have you? You've played Dota, of course.
I have, yes.
Well, I have these little Demi heroes. I have like a Slark, a Crystal Maiden, a Vengeful Spirit, a Tiny, and a Doom. Yeah. I have those in my right in front of me, actually.
Nerd, put some nerd in chat.
Yeah, nerd. Let's see some nerd. I'm a total nerd, so I went ahead and bought them, right? Because I love them. You know, IQ is that sweet booty. Let's see some butt stuff in chat too. My new emote. Come get it, guys, on twitch.tv/microwave_gaming. Go there now. But you get nice little chibi stuff. I'm gonna be giving some away. When they come out, I don't know if they're EU yet, but I know they're America. So I'm gonna be giving those away to subscribers soon once they come available. So don't worry, guys. We got that coming. So again, patch 2.2.2, August 9th, confirmed. Pulse update. Yes. Valkyrie update, or the Valkyrie cam update fixed. No idea when we're getting the servers yet. There's going to be like a mini soft patch inside, on that day. We don't know exactly. We don't know the patch notes, but rest assured, once we get the patch notes, we will be here Friday at 10:30 talking about it in depth and giving our opinions based on it. For those of you tuning in now, it is Friday on Twitch. We're going to be answering some of the questions that you guys have, because you guys have been sitting here hanging out. We're going to be answering those questions. Don't worry. If you're here on YouTube, you're watching this. This will be posted on Sunday. I don't know when, kind of whenever. It takes me 2 hours to render this and 2 hours to upload it, because it's ridiculous. So it'll be here on, you'll be watching this on Sunday. If you guys want to come on and hang out and talk to us live on Twitch, the link down below, obviously, you can come and hang out with me and Game Addict. T-shirts are on the way on my end. Right now, Game Addict has them on sale. I don't know how many days are left. Can you extend
it? Basically 2 days. I cannot extend it, guys. The way that this works, the way that it works is once the sale is over, they are shipped. So there will be multiple sales, obviously, and more products to go up.
Right,
this is just initial run.
This is initial run, right? So you're gonna be doing more, right? So keep an eye on that. We're gonna have some Best Buddy T-shirts. We're gonna be bringing you guys the stuff that you guys have been begging for, and definitely in the YouTube comments. I mean, I see it all the time. Where's my damn shirt? We have them coming. Don't worry. So with that, guys, here on YouTube, we appreciate you guys watching. I know it's kind of boring, but this is specifically to minimize on your computer and just play while you're playing some other game, or you're cleaning, or whatever you're doing. I'm working on getting this podcast on iTunes. Trust me, I read your comments and I know you want it so bad. It's I have to do that. Trust me, it's on the list. Now I want to say that my next stream schedule will be Tuesday, starting Tuesday, I will be streaming at 9 in the morning to about noon or 1 o'clock, depending on how things go. So I am changing my schedule so you can hang out then too. That means, I guess, that the podcast will be on a different day, but we'll talk about that another time. We're going to go ahead next week. We'll be at 10 p.m. again, but I don't know about after that. So with that, YouTube, that's all the time we have for today. Really appreciate the support, the love for the Best Buddy Squad. If you guys have any questions, come on by Twitch on Friday and let us know. GameMac, do you have anything that you want to add to it on a closing note?
No, I just want to say thanks, guys, for being here with us. We love fucking doing this for you. And yes, it really makes us happy if you guys enjoy this, to make sure to let us know.
Yeah, let us know what we could do better or what we could change. Obviously, we're not going to be playing the game, because when you're playing the game, it's difficult to talk about the conversations and stuff, and that's not what a podcast is, you know. So this is what it is, the Q Simulator podcast. It's not going to change, but any ways to improve it, we would absolutely appreciate it. And with that, YouTube, we will see you guys next week. Take it easy.